If you want to see values for your data item over time, you are going to be using the multiple value functions in PyDataLink. As you can see, there are three multiple value functions available. The first one is the compressed data function. It gives you the raw data stored in the Py system. So these are the ones that have been recorded and passed the exception and compression. When you look at the graph, you can see that the values are not evenly spaced. The sample data function returns evenly spaced interpolated values for a Py point or Py AF attribute over a regular interval. When you sample the values, you need to be careful and think about how you are going to sample in order to not skip any important events or peaks in your data stream. Looking at the graph with the sample data function, you will have no idea what was happening in your process, for example, between 9 a.m. and 10 a.m. here. The time data function returns actual or interpolated sample values for a Py point or AF attribute at a specified timestamps. Alright, it's time to practice and see how to use those functions. So in this hands-on, we would like to analyze the archived values of the external temperature of mixing tank 1 in our daily report for the first 2 hours of every day. So we know by now that we will use the compressed value function for that. We would also like to see this temperature value every 10 minutes during these 2 hours. So which function will be used for that? The sample data function. We are also interested in doing a comparison between mixing tank 1 and mixing tank 2 at the timestamps where there is a value archived for external temperature of mixing tank 1. So we are going to achieve that with the time data function. Okay, let's first build a template for our report. Type data item in cell A1. Start time in cell A3, end time in cell A4, and time interval in cell A5. Now click on cell B1 and go to search. Make sure you are connected to the OSIsoft database and type in external temperature in the search box. Select the external temperature of mixing tank 1 and mixing tank 2 and click OK. Now type the start time of T in cell B3, which refers to today at midnight, and time of T plus 2H in cell B4, which refers to today at midnight plus 2 hours, so today at 2 a.m., and time interval of 10 minutes, so type in 10 m. When your template is ready, we are ready to query for the Py data. So we will start by obtaining the compressed data for mixing tank 1 external temperature. So let's click on cell C3 and select the compressed data function. Refer to cell B1 as our data item. Select the start and end times. Select height count and show timestamps and click OK. Now let's do the same for mixing tank 2 in cell G3. So click on cell G3 and select the compressed data function. Refer to cell B2 as our data item. Select the start and end times, select height count and show timestamps and click OK. Now we will obtain the sample data for mixing tank 1 external temperature. So let's select cell E3 and go to the sample data function. Refer to mixing tank 1 external temperature as our data item. Select the start and end times. Here we see an additional field for the time interval. Let's refer to cell B5. Select show timestamps and click OK. When we try comparing the timestamps of the compressed data for the two mixing tanks, we can notice they are not the same, so the comparison cannot be accurately done. To have a better comparison, we will use the time data function and get the external temperature of mixing tank 2 at the timestamps in column C. So let's select cell I3 and click on time data function. select the external temperature of mixing tank 2 as our data item. For the timestamp, select the timestamps in column C, so the timestamps from the external temperature of mixing tank 1. And now click on Apply. Now our report is ready to go. Thanks for watching.